Hello everyone, welcome to Art Thrill Studio, and here I am Anuja, who's going to take you forward with our formations of fish in Madhubani painting. It's very important for us to know the importance of this element as it symbolizes the good luck, fertility and prosperity. We often see Madhubani paintings have fish as a very, very common element. Most of them will have it. The existence of fish means that all the elements are in harmony and thereby accelerates prosperity. These symbols have a strong association with the Feng Shui philosophy as well. We find many elements like turtle, fish, tree of life, bamboo, sun and moon, and elephants that have importance in Feng Shui as well as in Madhubani. So it can be stated that installing a Madhubani painting in your house will bring immense benefits of Feng Shui as well. So let's get started and make few pretty fish which you can try and put it in your house. And let's hope for some prosperity to come in. So let's get started. So we will start with the basic fish shape, which we can also call it as a leaf. Now we will double the line and give it a Madhubani vibe here. Again, the neck bands, and we have to do some design. I prefer a scallop design with black outlines filled to give it intensified look. Now this is a scallop design to make the scales, and I will be filling it with the lines, that is kachani, alternately so that I can fill the colors also. Now just making the scales deepen. So you can go ahead and make any sort of design that you want to. So I'll be doing a lot of fishes, and you will see different kinds of filling designs. These are the fins, and we will again fill it with kachni lines, a single pattern. If you want more colors to be on your fish, you might not fill it with the lines. Whereas if you want kachni to be the major part, then you have to fill major parts, and only few will be left for color. Now again, following the same shape, we will make another fish. Again, outlining it. Here you will see a slight variation in the fish scales and the fin pattern. The mouth is a little open, so if you have to make it, you just fill it with the dark shade, which will again come with the lines. And here these are the leaf shapes. I will do the negative filling, and then this will brighten up. So now once that is done, the black portion, the blackening of the background is done. It brightens up the picture. You can go ahead and make different patterns of kachni to fill your fish. It can be slant lines, straight lines, dashes, dots, wavy lines, scallop design, anything that is filling up the whole gap, that is kachni, just to fill it up with small design. So here these are my very tiny, tiny scales. And now I'll go on the fin and just do the dot pattern. This is my second fish. Now going on to the third, I will make the same kind of a shape, just showing it a little movement, so that the tail is curled, that shows that a movement is there. Again, double lining it and the fins. Just breaking your fish into three portions. One is the head, the other portion is the body, the other back is the tail. So if you just find and make the lines on those, then you will know which side will go better with which picture and like which design. So here again it is the filling, and I will go ahead and do the same pattern of polka dots and the stripes in the in this fish as well. So here, if you're liking my video, do not forget to subscribe my channel. There will be many tutorials on Madhubani coming right one after the other, which will help you to understand the basic formation, the importance of that in Madhubani, and also the how to draw. Now this is my fourth fish, and this is quite straight and simple. Again, double outlining the whole thing and making the fins go till the end of the tail. So giving it a very streamlined look. Very, very proportionate and balanced design. And we will again fill it with kachni and the dotted lines. So if you want any particular design, when you will practice the Madhubani, you will kind of develop your own fondness for any particular design or the combination of the two. And then you will do. Now here is one motif which is having two fish. Now roughly I'm making a circle and then fish on both the sides. If you need help, you can make the circle with pencil, with any lid or compass, and then make your two shapes like in a whirlpool. They are just chasing one another. It's a fish play. So now we have to fill up our both the designs, and likewise the head, the body and the tail. First thing is make the sections of head, body and the tail. And then you can go ahead and do the filling as per your wish. Here I am doing both of them in the same kind of design. And since this is forming a circle, I will also make some extended design on the outer circle, so that it can be used on the motif. So you can put it at the blouses, your shirt backs, your blouse backs, your dresses, your kurtas, anything. Even while gifting the envelopes, you can make these small motifs. Again, just making it like a mandala style. And giving it a beautiful ending by small flowers. Madhubani looks very, very incomplete if it doesn't have the second outline to it. So we will go ahead and do the second outline as well once this is complete. Yeah, so second outline, and then it will save the picture. And this is my kachni again. So you will see, as you do the kachni or you do alternately kachni, you will see that one design separates itself from the other, and then each and every design that you make comes very brightly. Now here this is a fish pattern that I'm doing it for a border. So it is a straight line, two parallel lines, and then I'm just creating wave lines, and these wavy lines I am just incorporating it like a fish. One going left, the other right, again the left and the right. This will look beautiful in any of the borders. Just do the double outline to separate each one of them. And then I'm just separating it from the background so that we get the edge of the design. Alternately, I'm filling it up with a line pattern. So one fish is clear white and the one is having a little stripy edge. Now here, it's any design that you want to. If you have not seen my border videos, you can view my border videos and then you will get the idea of how we can incorporate the designs in borders. Now here I'm going to make a very simple one but very beautiful. I've made a line with scallop designs and then some mountain kind of patterns. So you will see three, but it will transform into fish because it is my fish series. I will make them as fish. So I'm just making, tiling them up. So just one finds the way between the two. And then the face makes it beautiful. So I'll make the face for each one of them. So it is a shoal of the fish, a group of the fish. And we'll have total six of them moving ahead in a group. Here I'm checker pattern and filling the dots. It looks like as if it is perfect scale pattern. And then filling the border with filling design. This is my shawl. Now the next picture I'm going to do is the combo of two elements, that is the fish and the flower, lotus. So here I make a center line and make two fish, very symmetrical, left and right. I will do the second outline. As you can see, I did the second outline and my fish looks complete. Now I'm separating it from the body, the face from the body, and this is the design in the body. Now these are my fish just sticking together and moving ahead. And you can go ahead and fill up whatever design you want to or whatever theme you are doing. The face, and here is the eye. So this is a fin, but now it is going to take a shape of a lotus. So this picture has two elements, a lotus and fish. Both of them are very auspicious and alternately I will design it. So one are the dashes and the other has some filling design. The one which is just the repetition of the fish pattern. How I did the fish face, the same way I'm repeating it on the petals as well. So this is my motif. Coming down to the next one, this is a very huge fish. And not so charming, but yeah, they do exist, so why not? So here you will have a wide open mouth wherein big sharp teeth, big round eye, and then I'm just making it in stripe patterns. There are different bands and going till the tail. Now I'll go ahead and fill it with one type each. In one I'm just showing the fish, big fish and the small fish. Now again the scallop design and all the negative portions are being filled jet black. Just a little beautification with detailing. As much detailing you want you can add. If you don't want that much detailing or intricacy, you can just fill it with colors. Depends on your wish. the fins on both the sides, and again filling it simply with the kachni. So majorly all the fish, they have a very predominant method which I have opted for, is the line and the dot pattern. So these are cute little fish serving as the bait for the big one. Now here is one motif which has three fish all together in one picture. So it is a very beautiful motif. Again, the same simple design of a fish, then another fish, a smaller one, outlining it to separate from both. Again, one more very small. So we can see that there are three fish. And now we will go ahead and do the designing of all the three differently so that they do not mix up and they stand separate. You can use these fish patterns anywhere. I have a lot many videos which have bookmarks on fish, which have motifs on fish. Just filling it alternately, giving it a little more gap, and that is what we have, our fishes ready. So we have done around 10 fish patterns. Some are single simple fish, then there are some together. If you like my channel, do subscribe for more